In this section, we're going to use the User Administrator Editor to create a group of users and add two users to it, called Operator and Engineer. And to each user, we're going to assign different authorizations to allow them to do their job. In runtime, users will be able to log on and perform the job functions that they have and deny them access to the ones that they don't. So let's get started. We're going to start with User Administrator. We'll just double click and the editor opens in the Configuration Studio. So if I select the top level, then in the work area, we can see the groups, we can see all the users and authorization levels. Authorization levels are how we allow operators to interact with the application user interface. So we can add to this if we want. I'll just add a new number and let's just call this set point entering. So we can add as many of these authorizations as we wish. Next, I'll add a new group and just call it users. Now with users selected, you'll notice that we have all our authorizations and we can assign default authorizations to new users who are created in the group. So I will select all of these and I'm going to unselect a few of them that we don't want everybody to have. So I'll unselect change pictures, confirm alarms, project manager. So now let's create users. Right click new user and give it a name. And in the properties of this user, notice that the password is pink. That means we have to give it a password. We're just going to use the word password because this is a demo project. It gives you a security indicator. And we have some properties that we can set here if you're using Web Navigator, Web UX, and things like that. And for our operator, we will give that account the ability to change pictures and remove set point entering. I'll create one more operator. And this is the engineer. And we want our engineer to have everything except web access, which we are not configured for now. And we need to set the engineer's password. And I'll just give it the same thing, password. So now we have our users created. Next, we're going to go into WinCC Explorer and open the project properties. We will go to shortcuts and we're going to set a keyboard shortcut to log on. So I'll select log on, click in this box and just hit the keystroke that I want to use and click assign. This will allow us to hit Control L when in runtime to pull up the log on dialog. Now we need to go into our graphics designer pages and assign authorization levels to the objects. So we'll start with our navigation buttons. I'm just going to lasso all of our navigation buttons. In the properties dialog, you can see it says multiple selection. So that means it's properties of all these buttons. And under miscellaneous, we have the authorization attribute. And if we double click here, it gives us the same list that we saw in User Administrator. And we're going to assign one of these to be required in order to access these buttons. So we will do change picture and just click OK. So each individually, these buttons have the change picture authorization. To stop runtime, we will use Project Manager. And then for our acknowledgement button, we will use confirm alarms, and then we're going to click save. Next, we will open our alarm screen, and we'll double click to access the properties of our alarm control. We can assign authorization levels directly to buttons on the toolbar. So we will do confirm alarms for single acknowledgement as well as group acknowledgement. Click OK, save. Next, we'll go to our overview screen. And on our IO fields, I'm going to select one IO field and hit Control A, and it will select every IO field on the picture. That's one of my favorite features of WinCC. And on the authorization level, we will use our set point entering, which was the new one that we created. and click OK and hit save. Back on main PDL, we need to set up to show the username who's logged on. So we're going to select our text box. And on the text property, we're going to right click and do tag. And under internal, we have system tags that are denoted with an @. These are tags created by WinCC for your use. And we are just going to choose @currentUser and click OK. That way, any logged on user's name will show in this box, and we'll click Save. So now we're just going to test in runtime. So in runtime, if I try to access the controls where we added authorizations, I'm not able to access because no one is logged on. You can see in the username area, it's blank. So if I hit Control L, let's log on first as the operator. And now we can see that the operator's logged on and the operator has the ability to now navigate. But if they try to do something that they don't have authorization for, then of course they get this message. So next I will log in as engineer. And we see the engineer is logged on, and the engineer has the right to change these set points and also has the right to navigate. And if we generate an alarm, then we can go to our alarm control and acknowledge alarms.